Brother Lewis. Amen.
Father, I stretch my hand to giving thanks to Pastor Cotton, to all my brethren in the ministry on this roster, to you, the Rising Star family. I thank God for another opportunity to be able to pass this way once again. Since the last time, I have to report God is still good. He's still on the throne.
Yes.
He's still sitting high and he's still looking low.
Oh, yes.
That's just good news right now. He brought us from last week to this week.
Yes.
God has been good to all of us.
Oh, yes.
Looking out over this congregation and looking at this pastor's aid committee, I have to agree with Pastor. Y'all sure look good.
Amen.
Amen. God has been good to y'all. I don't know if you recognize that, but I'm going to tell you, God has been good to y'all. God has brought y'all from a mighty long way. Amen. And I just thank God for what he's done for y'all and is still doing for y'all over here. I'm still praying for Rising Star Baptist Church. I thank God that my brother is over here. This is my big brother here. Is over here. I thank God that he's over here. I hope you all appreciate him. I can tell by the way y'all doing, how the preachers were doing in the study. I know they love their pastor. So I hope you all do too. There is a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord. Coming out of the third chapter of Daniel. Verses 23 through 27. That's Daniel, the third chapter.
Yeah.
Verses 23 through 27. I still hear pages turning. Amen. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
The 23rd verse said, and these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar, the king, was astonished and rose up in haste and spake and said unto his counselors, did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire?
On,
they answered and said unto the king, true, O king. He answered and said, lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt, and the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Then Nebuchadnezzar said, came near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace, and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come hither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth of the midst of the fire, and the princes, governors, and captains, and the king's counselors, being gathered together, saw these men, upon whose bodies the fire had no power, nor was a hair of their head singed, neither were their coats changed, nor the smell of fire had passed on them. For a few minutes, I'd like to talk on the subject, God stepped in on time. God stepped in on time. It ought to be some loud hollering in here. God stepped in on time. Now, I was listening to the choir as they singing. They started off with All Night Long. Sometimes when you're going through trials and tribulations, you're going to cry all night long. Let me tell you, some things, circumstances, and situations can put you down on your knees to where you want to get up, but you can't get up. But I found that when you cry all night long, there is somebody sitting high that's listening to your every cry. And when he gets you up off of your knees, you ought to be able to stand and testify like the choir, oh, how precious is the name of Jesus. You ought to get up hollering that. Nobody ought not to pull your coat down to make you say, oh, how precious is the name of Jesus. If he brought you off of your knees from all night long, then we find that after he brought you off of your knees and you were able to say, oh, how precious, you ought to be able to tell somebody the reason I'm here right now is because when I was down and out, when the world had counted me out, when friends walked away from me, when relatives turned their back on me, God stepped in on time. You ought to be able to say that. Nobody ought not have to make you say that. You ought to be able to say that. It shouldn't have to depend upon the elderly to say how God stepped in on time, because I know I got some cotton pickers in here. I know I got some wagon riders in here. And I know that when they was about to give up, they can say God stepped in on time. But what about me? I haven't picked no cotton. I haven't rode on no wagon. I had it made when I was born. But guess what? I can still testify in something I've been through. God stepped in on time. That's good news to know right now. That's good news to know that when you look around and nobody's standing there but you, and when you have to face something that you know that nobody could get you out of, and when God brings you out, you ought not be ashamed to say God stepped in on time. Some of us, I'm afraid, we act like we brought our own selves. But can I tell you something? God brought you when you couldn't bring yourself. God brought some of us when we was too mean to bring ourselves. If it had not been the Lord who was on my side, I wouldn't be here right now. God called me. I'm so glad man didn't call me. God called me. If I had listened to man, I'd have been preaching 20 years ago. But God called me. God knew the right time to bring me to the pulpit. Too many times we rushing God. You can't rush God. You got to learn how to wait on the Lord. You got to learn how, when you having your good days and then your bad days, you need to learn how not to complain, but to accept God for who he is. is the way Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego walked. These were three Hebrew boys that were pure Jews, but they were captured and brought into a strange city. That let us know that when God saves you and sends you back into a strange city, you ought to be just like these Hebrew boys here. You ought not bow down to everything that's going on all around you. The Hebrew boys was in a situation to where they were outnumbered by everybody. Let me tell you, the majority is not always right. Can I tell you that? The majority is not always right. Because when it came down to Jesus going on the Calvary, the majority said he was guilty. The majority is not always right. But we live in a world where people are still playing strange music. They still want the Christians to bow down to what they believe in. You got Jehovah's Witnesses that want you to bow down to what they believe in. You got the Muslims to bow down to what they believe in. But I'm so glad that I learned in my Sunday school lesson just today to trust and believe in God's love. Because while I was yet a sinner, Christ died for me here. So I do not mind telling somebody that God stepped in on time. So here it is again, these three boys. They were one that at first had found favor in the king's eyesight. But when it came down to them picking the king and choosing the king of kings, they chose to pick the king of kings. Let me tell you, the world is not going to like us when we pick the king of kings, because there are some city officials would like for us to bow down to what they believe in and not stand on what we believe in. I tell you, if we would have stood on what we believe in, I tell you, that mayor that we got right now would not be down at City Hall. But because we didn't stand like we should stand, because we bowed down to what the world said, we now have a mayor that's living contradictory to what we believe in. But I tell you, God is still sitting high, and he's still looking low. I tell you, these Hebrew boys here, when they find the king, found out that they wouldn't bow down. The first thing that the people did was they were watching these Hebrew boys. They were watching every step and move that they made. Don't you fool yourself. Somebody is always watching you. You can be on your job. Somebody is watching you. You can be in your neighborhood. Somebody is watching you. And the minute you step out of the line they are holding you accountable to, then they want to run and tell somebody else. They'll always talk about what's going on bad in your life. But they won't never say anything good about your life. So these men came running to the king here. They say, "Oh, king, didn't you say that when you play this music, everybody around ought to bow down to this music?" And then the king said, "Yes, I did make that decree here." I tell you, but then they say, "But there are three men that did not bow down." Now, how is it that these people looked all around and just found these three Hebrew boys? I tell you why, because they were living the life of Jesus Christ here. I tell you, everybody else can do something wrong, but the minute a child of God goes against the grain, somebody have a problem with it. I tell you, then the king said, "Bring these men to me." He brought them to him, and then the king said, "Well, I'm going to give you another chance." But what I like about it is these three Hebrew boys told him, they said, "Now, we don't need to be careful in how we answer you, king. You can play your music all night long, but we will not bow here." I tell you, this is where they believe in God's love. They said that even the God that we serve, he can deliver us. But if he choose not to deliver us, we still know that he can heal. How many times have you told somebody, I might be going through this right now, I might be going through that right now, but I tell you, God is able to bring me out here. But even if he don't bring me out here, I'm not going to give up on Rising Star. I'm going to keep coming to Rising Star here. I'm not going to give up on Bible study. I'm not going to give up on the choir. I'm not going to give up on Sunday school, because I know that God can bring me out. I'm going to stay down on my knees. God is looking for somebody to stand on his promises. I tell you, the king told the men, heat that furnace 7 times hotter. I tell you, he heated the furnace. I tell you, then they tied these Hebrew boys up and threw them down in a fiery furnace. Can I park here a minute here? Notice here that he threw them down. They fell down on their knees in a fiery furnace. I'm sure that when they fell down, they didn't have time to pray Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I tell you, they went down on their knees. They say, God, here we are. We stand in on your promises. I tell you, you can talk about me as much as you please, but when I go down on my knees, God will show up on time. I tried him, and I know he will. I'm so glad that God will step in on time. I tell you, the king began to look in that furnace. Now the furnace was hot because it burnt the 3 men that threw them in. God has a way of taking care of your enemy. God has a way to making your enemies your footstool. The king looked inside of the furnace after Shadrach and him had finished praying. They looked around. The king said, didn't we throw 3 men in the fiery furnace? The men say, yes, we were standing right here. Nebuchadnezzar took another look in the fiery furnace. He say, yes, but I see 4 men. I know we threw them in on their knees, but I see them right now. I see them walking around in a fiery furnace. God will allow you to walk around. Enemy might think they got you. Enemy might think they done tripped you up, but God will allow you to walk around. I tell you, they walking around in a fiery furnace. Nothing was wrong with them. I tell you, they still had on the same clothes. I tell you what happened to them. God stepped in on time. We have 3, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. They were working together. God was working on the outside. Jesus showed up on the inside. The Holy Spirit took the fire, took the sting out of the fire. The Holy Spirit took all the smut out of the fire. God will step in on time. I'm so glad when I look over history right now. You know, a long time ago, we faced at a fiery furnace. Hell was our fiery furnace. But Jesus came all the way down from Calvary Cross. He walked around down here. I tell you, they talked about him, but he kept on walking. They spit on him, but he kept on walking. They pierced him in the side, but he kept on dying. But I tell you that one day, on a Friday evening, he died. They laid him in a borrowed tomb. I tell you, if you allow my mind to just go back, they tell me that death and the grave begin to have a conversation here. I tell you, the death called down to the grave. Say, grave, do you still have him? I tell you, the grave told death. Yes, I got him. I got Abraham. I got Isaac. I got Jacob. I got Jeremiah. I got Isaac. I got David. I got Solomon. I got Matthew. I got Mark. I tell you, but early that Sunday morning, this time, the grave called death. Called death. I know I bragged about who all I had down here, but I tell you, early, early, early Sunday morning, something happened. I tried to hold him. I couldn't hold him. I tried to wrap my arms around him, but he was too wide. I tried to go down and grab his leg. He was too low. I tell you, I tried to reach up and grab, but he was too high. Early, 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 while we were standing, fiery burning, God did, stepped in on time. Are you glad? Are you glad? Are you glad? Are you glad? I'm so glad. I'm so glad. I'm so glad. I'm so glad. He paid the price for me a long time ago. I can remember I was walking around down here, no God on my side. Friends didn't like me. Friends turned their back on me. Relatives turned their back on me. But God did. God did. God did. He stepped in on time. Has done it for you. Can I get a witness in here that no God will, that no God has, that no God is still here, stepping in on time? Have you tried him? Have you tried him? Have you tried him? He gives you a new way of walking. He's a burden bearer. He's a heavy load sharer. He's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. I got him. I got him. I got him. I got him. I tried him. I tried him. I tried him. I tried him. And I found out that he's all right. Have you tried him? Have you tried him? Is he bread when you get hungry? Is he water when you get thirsty? Is he a wheel? Is he a wheel? Is he a friend? Have you tried him? Have you tried him? You ought to try him. He's God. Same God. On Monday, same God.